preparation exercise for the first phase has also been carried out. Where we are now is that the Estate Surveyors Registration Board, as referred to as SVABON, are currently reviewing the valuation that was carried out. Then, after that, the sales guidelines too for the process has also been approved. That's why I said in the next coming weeks, that process for the first phase will commence. But for the valuers, they've already been shortlisted, they've also been engaged, they've carried out the valuation exercise. What slowed down the process a little bit was the pandemic, since there was closure as at May. Again, let me also say that while the delayed process, as you rightly mentioned, that advert then was for expression of interest. And then all that required processes had to take place. We got the final approval of the National Council on Privatization in February this year. And immediately, the valuers were engaged. They started. So as we speak, the valuation report is ready. The sales agents are ready. The sales guidelines are ready. We are just set to go for the first phase of the 52 assets.
On the issue raised by my brother.
Yes.
The federal government, in noting the assignment of the implementation committee on the alienation of federal government property, through the addendum to lease the federal government property all over the country, at the 33rd meeting on conclusion 10, noted all these things, and number three says, the council noted that the landed properties of other public agencies, such as the Power Holding Company of Nigeria, Nigerian Telecommunications PLC, Nigeria Ports Authority ETC, were currently being leased or slated for lease by the Bureau of Public Enterprises and the various agencies, whereas many of them had earlier been offered for lease by the implementation committee.
Yes.
I would like to state that the implementation committee never even had access to funds on the sale of these properties. They are immediately moved to the dedicated account, and you know, the dedicated account with the Central Bank of Nigeria. Mm-hmm. So, which is in line with the presidential directive here.
Okay.
Thank you very much, sir.
You know, and take a position in your presence, listen to their submission before we revert back to you. That was our plan, because we can't shave people's head in their absence. You know, we'll step down your appearance for today until we get to hear from CBN, Nigerian Ports Authority, BPE, and other relevant agents CBN. Of government, CBN, that participate in the selling of government assets. CBN is not here. Nigerian Ports Authority is not here. BPE is not here. Mr. Clark, please do a letter to Mr. President through the office of the SGF and the Chief of Staff to the President, an attached copy of invitation to these agencies, and notify the office of the refusal of the to appear before the Parliament, and give them 7 days. Eh? Yes, and it will appear within 7 days, okay? PIC, over to you quickly.